Hi, Chris Davis here with ChannelFireball.com doing a Pauper Daily event. I'm running 20-20-20 white, as you can see. 20 lands, 21 drops, 22 drops. Nothing too spicy about this, just playing War Falcon and some soldiers. Trying a copy of Veteran Armorsmith and a copy of a Krazen Squire. Seeing how this stuff works out, if any of it is useful cards. Not doing anything too crazy, running some removal in the board, some ways to kill artifacts and enchantments. Holy Light, I'm still running because it seems sort of overall useful, like against blue decks, for instance. They're going to have a lot of 1-1s. I don't know, that's something that might not make the cut moving forward, but keeping it in for now, in case I see like any goblin decks or something. It's certainly good against goblins, but we'll see how this works moving forward. Still running kind of a late game-ish mana base. I want to be able to not draw too many lands as the game moves forward. We'll see how much that harms me. Some removal is useful because there's still stuff like Affinity out there, so I want a little bit of removal in the main deck. I do still want Squadron Hawks because they're a nice attrition tool. And that's basically the deck. I will be back with round one very quickly. And I hope to have your viewership. Okay, so here we are with round one. I'm on the draw, didn't win the die roll. But I will be trying to survive what looks like a Cloud Post matchup here. The double Squadron Hawk hand, I've seen better. I guess I can try and bait him countering my first Hawk. If he plays land go. But, Cloud Post decks don't usually play land go. Cloud Post Prism? Oh, no Prism. Okay. I'm spared that at least. Turn 3 Mole Drifter? Aw, yeah. I legitimately can't possibly win. I probably could have just run my Sky Hunter into it. That might have been better, actually. Maybe not. Alright. Get in there, Squadron Hawk. You can do it. Yay. Handful of Squadron Hawks. I guess I don't want to F6. Probably won't matter, though. Cloud of Fairies. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Now it could matter. Hopefully that worked. Okay, it did. Yeah, I don't think I want to just let him do this. Good old Ghostly Flicker. Horribly warping this format I love. I still feel like I'm pretty dead here. I mean, he doesn't have to have much to just annihilate me. Oh, snap. Now I can F6. Okay, he's got the wall. That's very bad for me. So yeah, I'm pretty much toast. If I'd drawn Journey to Nowhere, I guess I would have had a shot. I could have moved Bone Splitter here also, but kind of pointless. I guess it might have mattered. I'm actually going to do it now so that I'll have it for next turn. But it could just be that I'm about to watch a very long turn. Okay, he gains another 4 life. Okay. I mean, now he's got 4 life glimmer posts that he can flicker also. I don't actually think it's worth it to prolong this madness. I'm just dead. Okay, so what do we have? I don't think I want these rallies in this case. Don't know that I want to make any changes, really. Maybe I need to put some sort of counterspell on my sideboard. Like the white memory lapse. I don't know. It seems really bad. It feels like there should be something I can do against this. I'm wondering if I want Remotion Rally. It might speed up my clock, but I'm not sure that it does more than Journey to Nowhere. It probably does more than Journey. But it's probably also close. I'm gonna give it a shot.